Well, it's true there's a lot of geopolitics, but it's also true that I think this Davos has shown that, you know, if business and government and investors come together, we can do something about climate change, which is fantastic. I'm coming from a government where we put very high targets on reduction on emissions. And we cannot do it alone as a government. We do it with business, we do it with investors. And if we do right partnership, we can actually move fast. So I think that message came out of Davos, and I was very encouraged by the discussion I took part in.
Just remind us of the target you're aiming for, because I think there's been a lot of leadership from European countries, which then also raises a question about free riders in this equation. Right. So just tell us what you're aiming for and how you feel about others not achieving.
What we decided in Denmark is that we have a target of 70% reduction by 2030, so in 10 years. And honestly, we maybe know how to get to 60-65%, but we don't know how to get the last 5 or 10%.
Why is it so hard to get to the last mile?
Well, you don't have the technology or the knowledge or the policies yet. So we decided to do that anyway, because we think leadership is also about, you know, daring to aim for a higher target. And really, if you look at the planet today, if we really take climate change seriously, and we should, then we should deliver. I mean, you cannot negotiate with nature. Nature is fighting back, and we need to do something about it. So we have a high aim, high target, but then we also push, you know, the, you know, business, investors, government to deploy the right policy. And I'm pretty sure a country like Denmark, if we are innovative, and we are, then we can get there. For example, we established 13 partnerships with all parts of industry, shipping, food industry, also with the institutional investors, pension funds. We are all aiming at the same direction to get to 70% in 2030 in Denmark. And that model we would like to replicate globally, because if we do that, I think we have a chance to deliver on the climate action.
President Trump also touching on the subject, calling out some of the pessimists, but he did also commit to the One Trillion Trees initiative, a subtle tone shift for the president. But do you think the United States, the White House in particular, is doing enough, taking enough leadership at this point, given where we have seen the president on the past and when it comes to the environment?
Well, I think, I mean, we have there a disagreement. I mean, they withdraw from the Paris Climate Accord, and we think it's very important. But, you know, listen, there's so much happening. We interact not only with the government in D.C. or the White House, but also with states and cities that are champions of the green transition. And I see, you know, that happening quite fast now. People are also demanding a change, and I think cities and also companies are responding to that. And if government put the right regulatory framework, the right ambition, the right partnership, then we're able to get there. You know, so I hope that also that the U.S. That president will see the opportunity that you know the green business gives. I mean, you can be very sustainable and competitive at the same time. My own country, Denmark. If you see which country in Europe is the best place to do business, it's Denmark. You see, we are top of all rankings. At the same time, we have one of the highest ambitions on climate. So it goes hand in hand.
Where does this leave the trade situation? Because in the backdrop, if you want to bring about strong reforms, you need to have a strong economy. Right. I know a number of European countries are already concerned that there might be rebalancing of the trade conditions with the United States, given that the focus is shifting here. Yeah. Are you concerned about that trade fight with the United States?
You know, listen, I think we live in a world today in 2020 where we are in integrated economies, global value chains. So the idea that you can kind of put tariff walls or, you know, between states, that only hurts, you know, of course, trade, but also the deployment of the right technology to, for example, to fight climate change or to deal with big societal challenges, aging population or other things. So, and also environment. So therefore, I think we should, you know, instead of having trade wars, we should figure out what is the right regulatory framework to get to where we want. And that conversation is important to start with the U.S. We want to reform World Trade Organization. It's true that some of the members, China, there are examples of very unfair trade practices that we need to address. There, I agree very much with the U.S., but we need to do it within the multilateral system. That's the most effective way.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Bersecci, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.